Hello and welcome back to the Wellness Check. Today we are going to talk about something that you may or may not have ever heard of before, and it includes different protocols that we can use for EMDR. Up to this point, if you've watched any of my videos talking or discussing about EMDR, it has been those four letters. And that is an acronym that is really for a mouthful of words that stands for eye movement, desensitization, and reprocessing. So EMDR is the standard, the gold standard, the original protocol that was developed by Francine Shapiro, the one who created EMDR. And it really is the most comprehensive, right? So this is what we call the standard protocol. This is typically what we use with people. In a nutshell, and just as a basis for comparison, EMDR has 8 phases. And as an EMDR clinician, we walk through all 8 of those phases comprehensively to make sure that we have gotten all of the trauma desensitized and reprocessed, the D and the R. With EMDR, there's also what we call a 3-prong approach. So we are working on, with our clients, we are working on past, present, and future. Those are the 3 prongs within the 8 phases. Typically, the past has to do with the nature of the trauma. So what is it that you're coming in for? How can I help you with your trauma processing? These are the things of the past. Technically, it can be recent past, or it can be long, long, long time ago past, or an accumulation of repeated offenses or traumas throughout one's lifespan, which is what we call complex trauma. So that's the past. Also, we work into the present of how are these things affecting you now? What are you noticing about your relationships, your response systems, your reactions to the world around you? What are you noticing here and now? What are your negative core beliefs, the negative things that you think about yourself? What are the positive things that you think about yourself? How do we work through those and strengthen those where we need to and want to? Then we move into the future. And this is, the future is one of my favorite parts to work with. After we've really gone through a lot of the trauma work and reprocessing part, the future says, hey, in the future, what is an anticipated event that maybe you could expect where you normally would be triggered or upset or respond in a way that doesn't really feel good to you or the people around you? What is that anticipated event? Let's do some work on that using bilateral stimulation and a lot of the similar things that we use in EMDR to help you prepare for future anticipated events. And in the future work that we do, it's really beautiful. We talk about how is it that you'd like to see yourself in this event? What do you want to see yourself doing in this event? What do you want to believe about yourself while you're doing these things? Where do you want to feel those good things in your body? And we use bilateral stimulation to encode that or kind of put it into the nervous system. So sometimes when I'm talking to my clients about EMDR and looking at the desensitization portion of trauma processing, we're taking things out. We are combing through the history, we are untangling it, we are making really big insights, connecting new dots in a very intuitive way that is led by the client. It's beautiful. Whereas the reprocessing part and the future template stuff is putting stuff in to the nervous system. We are strengthening positive core beliefs. We are strengthening one's ability to feel more confident in their skill set and just in their body, mind, and soul about being able to confront things that normally have been very difficult for them. So that's, in a nutshell, the review on all things EMDR. It is exhaustive, meaning we are really looking at every single phase, making sure we're doing things completely and entirely so as to create a sense of longevity with your wellness and with the trauma processing that's being done. The experience of EMDR in comparison to what I'm about to talk to is very intuitive, meaning, let me talk about it this way. In EMDR, here's our target. We're talking about this thing, this client wants to come in and talk about this life event or these life events. This is what's been bothering that person. This is what's interrupting their daily life, and this is the work that they want to do. It's about an event or a person or a memory or a feeling. In EMDR, it's very, very, very normal, if not a guaranteed thing, that as the processing goes along, the client will begin to think about other things, and we call these channels. So we might start about topic A, but then after a set or so, the client might say something like, "That's really weird. I don't know why I'm thinking about this. It seems really off topic, but," and then we go into something that really seems off topic. It's not. It is a channel that is connected to the target in a neurological way, in the memory networks in the brain. So this is actually a really good process. This helps to connect a lot of dots all at once and make it so that we don't have to go through each and every trauma that the person has been through in order to feel relief and to feel better. We can actually extinguish a lot of different life events at once based off of one target. It's great. So there have been developments of other types, protocols of EMDR through time since Francine Shapiro's original protocol that are better suited for those who might find typical EMDR too overwhelming. And I'm very thankful that these protocols exist and these adaptations are here, and I'm going to go into them with you. So the acronym EMDR is all uppercase EMDR. The second adaptation I'm going to talk about is capital E, capital M, capital D, and lowercase r. EMDR, little r. Let's talk about what that means. With EMD, little r, the emphasis on the trauma processing is with the desensitization phase. Big D, little r. Not much on the reprocessing phase. Let me get into it just a little bit more in case this sounds confusing. Desensitization is probably the biggest phase of all of the eight phases of EMDR. It is the meat and potatoes. It is the crosshairs of getting into what I call the nitty-gritty. It's this really tough stuff. It's the stuff that we remember, that we relive, that bothers us in our day-to-day life and in our relationships. These are the traumas that we work through using the desensitization phase of EMDR. It includes bilateral stimulation. It includes a lot of resourcing and grounding and checking in with window of tolerance. Check out my window of tolerance video if you haven't seen that. EMD, little r, is really good for recent traumatic events. So maybe before or within the 3-month window. We typically talk about trauma as recent or more in the past. Recent means about 3 months ago or less. And the reason being is because on average, it can take a human brain to consolidate a memory and file it where it needs to go in about 3 months. So that's also something to kind of talk about with a client, is how long ago did this happen? If it happened a long time ago, then we know memory consolidation has already happened. We know that it is misplaced. The brain has got it stuck in this spot that is bothersome. But if it's less than 3 months, then memory consolidation probably hasn't completed yet, which means that there's a lot of very raw material that is coming up for the person, and it can be rather disturbing. Can feel like a big thorn in the side. And that's where EMD little r comes into play. When we are doing EMD little r, we are really narrowing down on the target. We do not want people to have a target and then go to all of these other seemingly unrelated channels. We don't want that, because the person is already overwhelmed, already overstimulated, probably has some challenges staying within the window of tolerance, and it's too much. It can actually be unhelpful to do EMDR, big R, in that way. So with EMD little r, this is our target. This is the thing that happened to me a couple weeks ago or a couple months ago, and this is how it's impacting me. And we do trauma work, trauma work, trauma work desensitization focus on this. As the trained therapist, we are making sure that any channels that do come up are solely related to the target. We help to narrow that down and to refocus to keep things on the target and the target itself, or the image or the feeling or whatever that one thing is. So that's part of the training, right? If we're doing EMD little r, this is not the time and place to make huge connections and connecting the dots here and there in vast ways. We are just really honing in on what is the disturbance, what has happened, how can we bring that activation level way, 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 way down. In all of the EMDRs, we use something that's called a SUDS scale, S-U-D-S, and another acronym, of course, but that is really a way for us to measure one's distress levels. So with EMD little r specifically, we want to bring a high SUDS level down, ideally to a zero. There's something that's called the economical one, and I get it, and sometimes the best we can get is a one out of a 10, but ideally we want that SUDS, that distress, that activation to come down to a zero when we think about that one thing and the connected channels that are related to that one thing. Okay, so lots of emphasis on the desensitization. We're not really worried about the reprocessing part nearly as much. The third type and the last type that I'm going to talk to you about is just EMD. So as you can imagine, you can kind of see this scale down as I'm talking about it. And EMD is full emphasis on desensitization phase. There's not really any reprocessing going on. And this is a wonderful intervention for those who have difficulty staying in the window of tolerance, who have abreactions when thinking or talking about the traumatic event itself, and is a very simplistic in comparison way to bring that SUDS level down quickly without a lot of sidetracking or distraction. So what does EMD, no R, look like? With EMD, to use this example again, here's our target. This is what we're focusing on. You're coming in for this probably more recent event, and we're feeling very overwhelmed by it. We don't allow any channels, okay? We are focusing just on the event itself. This one requires a lot of attention from the therapist to make sure that we're not sidetracking or getting off topic. We are focusing on an image, a smell, a sound, maybe the worst or most activating part of a traumatic event, singular. And what we're doing here is we're really narrowly defining what we're allowing the person to desensitize in a responsible way, especially if there are like dissociative symptoms that come along with this client, difficulty regulating, can't stand the window of tolerance, or outside of session, if they're not able to take care of themselves and they feel as though life is kind of crumbling around them, EMD is really, really good. It's just very specific, and it's actually pretty powerful. It brings down that SUDS pretty quickly, and it helps to also demonstrate to the client themselves that they are capable of thinking of or feeling or remembering something in a tolerable way and beginning to feel better about it when maybe they didn't think that that was something they could ever even do. Maybe they avoided that thought, maybe they couldn't think about it, or else, you know, they would just have a really bad day. EMDR really just says, hey, here's this thing. We're going to hit it head on, and we're going to hit it head on together, and it's going to feel better pretty soon. And we're not stretching out this big web of let's talk about all of these other channels that are related or not really related but are in the memory network together. It is concise. It is specific. And it is very measurable in terms of how are we helping this client navigate the trauma in meaningful ways. So in a nutshell, again, EMD and EMD little r are good as standalone trauma treatments, but they're also really good for precursor to EMD big R. There are times when people need to just put out a fire. I say, this is the fire we need to put out right now. We can't focus on anything else until we put this fire out. Let's do some EMD little r. Let's do some EMD to really nix this and make it feel so much more tolerable before we go into other things. So just as we funnel down, we can funnel back up. And a person who has undergone EMD and EMD little r often feel much more prepared cognitively, emotionally, to then go into the full standard protocol of EMDR and to be able to make those wide and vast connections and to allow their mind to go in cracks and crevices where it typically wouldn't go if we're just doing the other alternatives. So I want to let you know that if you have ever seen my videos or if you've done research on EMDR, maybe you've had some EMDR done by a trained professional and it was not for you. It was very overwhelming, or it re-traumatized you, or you left feeling worse than when you came. I want you to know that that's exactly what these interventions are designed to do, is to help keep you safe in your thoughts, in your feelings, in your memories. It is designed to tailor down the amount of processing that's happening to make it more manageable and to increase the productivity of the sessions in the session and outside the session. So I encourage you, go back to an EMDR therapist that knows how to do EMD little r, that knows how to do EMD, and start there. It'll feel much more manageable. You will be able to get to those therapeutic milestones much more efficiently and safely and appropriately. And then if there is time or if there is willingness to do the full EMDR protocol on something, you'll be in a much better place to do so. Okay, I hope that this helped. I hope that it was interesting to you. And as always, thank you for checking in with your wellness. I'll see you soon.